can do to people. Epstein served just over a year in jail. He's now on house arrest, which ends next month. Lawyers for the billionaire say Epstein has settled lawsuits.
He agreed to serve a total of 18 months in the Palm Beach detention facility, 12 for felony solicitation of prostitutes, and an additional 6 for procuring persons under 18 for prostitution. The conviction stemmed from several incidents from August of 2004 to October of 2005. The prosecuting attorney would not say how many female victims there are. She would only say there was more than one adult victim and more than one underage victim. After 18 months in the Palm Beach detention facility, Epstein will serve another 12 months house arrest at his Palm Beach home. The 54-year-old will be confined to his home except for work and other activities approved by his probation officer. In addition, Epstein will serve 12 months of community service at his own nonprofit, the Florida Science Foundation, and he has to stay away from minors. The guilty plea and deal end a years-long process that could have sent Epstein to jail for 15 years.
Federal charges. He was sentenced to 13 months in jail. Former Miami U.S. Attorney Alexander Acosta.
I know they hating on me, but I don't read comments. Whenever I tell her to come, she comes. Whenever it's smoke, we ain't running. Jump too hard, don't stand too close. You gon' fuck around.
I saw lots of people doing lots of hard work. And hard work didn't translate into success either. It wasn't what you knew or how hard you work. In fact, the people who were doing construction on Telegraph Avenue at that time were, I remember seeing some people sort of really, you know, coming in 7 o'clock in the morning, spending 12 hours working, and they still were neither happy nor successful. So it was not what you know. And what I learned in adult labor was lots of it, in fact, turns out to not necessarily who you knew, but who you came in contact with. I started Bear Stearns in 1976. Bear Stearns never had a training program. There was no course to begin. Alan Greenberg said he wanted me to learn each area of the business. So he thought the best place for me to start would be on the floor of the American Stock Exchange. And then later move up to the trading desk and learn all different areas of the firm, including the margin department. He was amazing. The way I saw it was physics, which was in fact based on a fixed number of rules. And you did experiments in physics that couldn't violate those rules. And if your experiment worked, you hit the target. Finance seemed to be a different metaphor for the same processes, but when you hit your target, you're able to fly first class in Paris. Making money is my priority and how I think about things. How money itself and how people make money and how money is made in different ways. So takeovers were a way to make money, commodity trading was a way to make money. And to me, the new one, as shows up in the impact of currency.
I was always very good at mathematics. What made you interested in
it? It was solving puzzles. And it's a strange feeling when you get the right answer to a puzzle. It leads to a later discussion about why people are so excited about puzzle solving. And why is the brain itself both a predictor of things and an inherent puzzle solver?
Mm-hmm.
In fact, I hate to sort of jump again to more brain things, but the idea of people receive pleasure when they get the right answer to a puzzle. And if the question is, when you say pleasure, does that mean there's a bit of dopamine release in the brain? What are the real mechanics? What's going on in someone's head when they have what Duchamp referred to as the aha moment? And there's a book I read when I first started on Wall Street, it was called Sell is a Four-Letter Word, which meant that people get attached to things and they refuse to sell, or they refuse to resign. And they make up lots of reasons why that they're sticking around, whether it be in relationships with other people, or with stocks. I mean, people have stocks that go down and they tell themselves, well, yes, I know I should have sold then, but I can't sell now. JP Morgan is probably the best private bankers in the world. The head of private banking department is just Staley. They know that you call up and ask, there's an opportunity here, and it might take very well some $100 million or whatever the number may be. I can give them an answer by the end of the phone.